guys, welcome back to the Shawties Podcast with your host, Sinead, and also my host,
Shasha.
Shalom.
My sisters.
Now, yes.
Yeah, guys, it's been a while since we've been on here. It's been a little bit. It's been about like a month or so.
Ooh, has it?
I think it's been
a while. Things have been busy. You know, right now, we just recently launched our family talk show, Onyx Family Dinner,
yes,
which is on the Onyx Family YouTube channel. So that was a big project that we were so excited to release.
And the first episode just came out today with Emmy Award-winning Emmanuel Acocho. He played for the Philadelphia Eagles back in NFL.
And also, he's just won an Emmy as well. Emmanuel Acocho.
And so, now he's making, he's really popular for his series Uncomfortable Conversations with a Black Man about race or something.
Uncomfortable Conversations with a Black Man about anything, really. It's just, that's what the topic is.
So
girls, we're going to have an uncomfortable conversation with each other right now.
We're going to
discuss a range of topics.
Today, we're talking about makeup.
Are we talking about makeup?
We're talking about
beauty.
Not just beauty.
What do you mean? Not just beauty. What else?
Those are fun topics. But I'm just saying about being comfortable in your own skin.
Yes.
And you know, not needing discussing the fact how makeup changes you.
Okay. So when was the first time? I just want to ask you guys. When was the first time you ever wore makeup? Do you remember?
Do I remember? Okay, what counts as makeup? Like
anything.
Anything, even lip gloss?
I remember my first time, I was turning 8, and we were going into a spa, like the spa thing, and we got lip gloss on, we got medi-pedis, and it was just like the first time I ever was did up. And if you look at the photos, I think we do have a photo. Not sure, but if we do, you can see we were feeling ourselves. Look at us showing off
nail. I know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
I don't know why. My first thought, even though this is my first time, but I remember wearing this lip balm. I was about 13, 14, wearing this lip balm, and it was slightly colored. And I mean, when I say slightly colored, I mean it was very slightly pink. And my mom immediately noticed and said, go wipe that off.
How old were you?
I was like 13, 14.
You know, are you sure?
Positive, because
I remember. Well, I just want you guys to know context. Back then, we were pastors' kids, so we couldn't really dress heavy.
Well, here's the thing: we just weren't allowed in our household. You know, we were very conservative. We were
we're a pastor's family.
Yeah, we just had a certain appearance of how we were looking.
Okay, so my first experiment with makeup, I was in grandma's house, right? And so I went inside her bathroom, and I saw this huge counter full of makeup, and so I was like, "Oh, I'm gonna experiment." Making sure no one looked. So I just grabbed, I didn't know this at the time, mascara. I didn't even put on my eyelashes. I put on my eyebrow.
Your eyebrows?
Because I thought it was going to give me a little arch, you know?
Yeah.
But I feel like some people use it for their arches, right?
No, mascara is not built for the eyebrows. It's just not.
You see, guys, I'm 22 right now, and I don't wear makeup. Like, I don't wear makeup every day. Well, for a few reasons why. But just because of the way I was raised, and because lack of interest. Mm-hmm. And lack of experiment. Not that I can get into it. I could if I wanted to, but I don't know. It's just not something that I necessarily desire to wear makeup every single day.
Yeah.
And it's so crazy when I see kids out there. They just, like, every time they go to school, they, like, put a full flush of makeup on. I'm like, whoa, is this, like...
It's time crazy. Consuming. You have to wake up earlier to do it. You have to spend some time. You gotta look at tutorials.
I know some people take it as a hobby, but it looks like a job to me.
And you know what? The thing is, the people that see it as a hobby and they're like, it's genuinely fun to them, I'm like, good for you. It's like an art to them, you know?
They exactly.
I'm like, man, that's great.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely. You know? But do you guys...
I thought you liked wearing makeup.
The thing is, I don't like to wear it on the daily, but I do have fun when I do wear it. So if I'm doing a music video, I could have a little fun with some glitter or whatever on the eyelids and blending and stuff. I have a little fun with that when I'm doing it for that. I just, on the daily, I'm not that kind of person to wear it on the daily.
Now, let me ask you a question. Do you think makeup really just changes you physically?
Like how you look? Well, I think that the more you wear it, it could probably clog up your pores and stuff like that. Probably give you a little more skin issues if you're not taking care of your skin, because like some people, they're really good at taking care of their skin,
right?
And they do the masks and stuff to replenish their face and then do the makeup, but and all that.
I just buy wipes from Walmart and just wipe it off. I don't
you
do
see,
any kind
if
of skin
you just
care.
Do that, you're gonna have skin issues because you're not fully cleaning it and fully rejuvenating your skin after wearing
makeup. Like buying products that will help, like skincare, like investing yourself in skincare.
Because if you're gonna invest in makeup, you gotta invest in the skincare part, or else you might ruin your skin, because makeup has a lot of chemicals, and it's just overall, it's like it's putting a bunch of chemicals on your skin, which absorbs all of it, which goes into your body. So I always consider that whenever I wear makeup. you know?
Oh my goodness. Yeah, I remember we were just having a photo shoot. I think not last year.
It was like 2 years ago, I think.
Yeah, 2 years ago. And we had all lined up in front of the... 2 years ago now.
I know what you're talking about. It was here, right?
Yeah, we all lined... Ago. Well, there's another photo shoot. We all lined up on the table. And she was showing us how to put on makeup for the photo shoot. Because none of us knew exactly how to put it on properly.
I still don't know.
So we all lined up on the table, just following this tutorial. And I thought it was just the funniest thing.
That was very interesting. Like, we really... Generally... We don't know how to apply. Well, I think that now I've learned because I had a little
practice. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And then, imagine if you guys had to do your makeup for Onyx family dinner.
Oh my goodness. I couldn't. I wouldn't. No. The lighting would just, like, catch me on my bad side. Just, like, sometimes I... Please, like, I literally forget my neck sometimes. And it's like,
I forgot.
It'll be like the makeup kind of stops at the chin instead of
it's
down to the neck.
And I don't even go, probably, and sometimes I don't even go all the way in my forehead. So it's just like,
yeah, see, that's an issue.
Exactly. Okay. I actually respect those who actually do a really great job with their makeup. So it's like, props to you. But I want to ask you guys,
How young is too young for makeup?
I just feel like that it's just not necessary.
Because you already have good skin as a kid.
Don't have good skin as a kid. But I feel like that when you're at those ages, it should be more emphasized to take care, do skincare more than covering it up with makeup.
That's a good point.
I think that it should be more effort in, instead of doing tutorials about learning how to do makeup, maybe tutorials on like, okay, find your skin, your best skin regimen. Okay, what helps dry skin? What helps oily skin? Finding those kind of fixes is better. Now, some people don't even wear makeup to cover up skin. Issues, but they wear it because they think that they don't look good enough. And then I would say to that, emphasize self-love before jumping to makeup.
It's interesting how you said skin issues, right? Because a lot of people, they have, what do you call it? Like that sort of acne disease, like acute, what is it called?
Acne, I think. Well,
I think there's another word for it.
I know.
That's acne, but.
No, yeah, there's another word to it, but yeah, they have that type of disease. And also they have like another sort of disease, like, I can't remember, but yeah, the acne thing. Like, do you think that in terms of acne, you think that it's best when someone, you know, can cover up, or do you think that it's more like.
Man, the thing is that you can't really judge per se someone who does not feel comfortable because they have really, really bad skin issues.
Yeah, I've never been there before.
Or burns. Like, that's what I meant to say. Burns.
Okay, that's a special situation. We're not talking about burn survivors.
Like, I'm not going to tell a burn victim, oh, don't wear makeup, you need to self-love.
Well, okay, we're talking about people who just have skin issues. That's it. Like, nothing horrific happened.
But even that, those people might not feel self-confident in their own skin. But I would say that you still got to learn to love yourself with and without the makeup. You still got to learn to love yourself because it's going to spread to other things if you're not loving yourself in certain areas.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Ooh, that was deep.
Yeah.
That was deep.
Oh, cystic acne.
Oh, cystic.
Ah, cystic acne. Oh, yeah, I've seen that.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, yeah, there's some special cases where you know, maybe a person would really want to use makeup for certain things. But if you're like already okay, right? And your skin is like already clear.
And people still wear makeup because they want to look older or they want to look more mature or.
But what makes you mature? Is it the lip gloss that makes you mature? Is it the arches of the eyebrow or is it the actual condition?
Because some people, you can't be like all makeup is bad or all makeup makes you look more mature because some people will only do lip gloss. Like I wear lip gloss. That's basically all I do.
I don't think that counts as makeup.
What? Really? What
some people do.
I think lipstick is. I think lipstick counts as makeup.
And then some people wear only eyeliner. They literally only wear eyeliner. And it's not even a lot of eyeliner, but they only put a little bit. Or mascara. They only wear mascara. But like, that's still makeup, but it's like, they're like, oh, I want to. I think that makeup, when it pops out a certain feature, like you're like, oh, I'm targeting certain features. I'm not necessarily changing myself, but I'm emphasizing. That's the thing. I think that there's two things that makeup can do. It can emphasize features you already have. So people that wear mascara might be like, oh, I want to show off my eyes more and like make it emphasize what color my eyes are, whatever. Then there's people that want to change how they look, and they're literally, some people will change like skin tone on their face,
right?
Face structure because they feel like their nose is too big or their chin is too square or their forehead is too high, like all that kind of stuff. And when it gets to that point, it's like you need to practice self-love and more than changing how you look.
Right.
Ooh, you appreciate it. Have you guys ever heard of permanent makeup surgery?
Permanent makeup
surgery? What is that?
Basically, we can make it look like you have a permanent makeup on. So, permanent makeup surgery, it's like tattoos. Needle basically pigments where you want it to go. It's like...
What?
It's, yeah, it's I've actually heard of that before.
Okay, listen. What if you said, hey, I want to permanently look like I have makeup on, right? And you're like, okay, what color do you want your eyeshadow to be? And you're like, I want blue. I'm only blue today. What if it just does not match all your outfits now from then on? You will always have blue eyeshadow.
Wait, so does that make you, so true. So does it make it look like you have always have like an arch sort of eyebrow?
Yeah, or
like,
it can make basically anything. I think they make their lips more pinker. You can
have permanent blush.
Yes, yeah, stuff like that. It's kind of like tattoos.
That's kind of extreme to me. It is extreme to me. Like that. I don't know.
Okay, but I would actually, not gonna lie, I would actually wear makeup more if I did not have to do the work of putting it on. If they created a mask. Elon Musk created a mask.
What?
He's an inventor. If he invented something where you could put it on your face and then just like peel it off and makeup is on you.
But that's like, not permanent. That's not permanent. So
No, I don't care about permanent. I just want, like, if I just want one day.
Are you saying that the only thing stopping you from wearing makeup is the fact that you just don't know how to do it?
Yeah.
So you would wear makeup every day if you could do it easily?
Yeah, why not? Like, if I could be like, psh.
Sorry, wait, are you saying that you're not satisfied with the way you look? Or are you saying that just for the fun of it? Okay, that's cool. I'm wondering why
What if someone said the same thing about exercise? You love exercise, right? You like the process of it. You like the whole...
Wait, but... No, okay, wait. But exercise is not...
No. Listen. Someone's like, man, I could just slap some abs on. Slap some muscles on.
That's body image issues.
No, your face is your body image. Your face is part of your body image.
That's like comparing drawing to, I don't know. Why are you comparing makeup to exercise? What?
Because some people just want that perfect body. So what if they be like,
mainly I exercise just for fun. It's not even for.
Okay, then let's discuss the topic of makeup for fun.
There's nothing wrong with that. If the issue comes is when you feel dissatisfied and you're putting on makeup because you're dissatisfied.
Fine. Yeah. But the thing is should that be an issue too?
What, being dissatisfied with yourself?
No, I'm saying,
like, if you want to up yourself.
Dissatisfied and they want to do something to better themselves and they feel like makeup is the way, should that be a bad thing?
Yes.
Well, okay, maybe.
No, is that like
a... Because you're encouraging bad self-esteem. What is your argument here?
I'm just asking. Should that be a bad thing? What if someone's like, you don't know me. You don't know that I feel great when I wear makeup and like, or like maybe wigs. Say someone was like, oh, I want to wear wigs because they don't like...
Oh, yeah. Mm. Like weaves, extensions. Yeah. You know, that's why I kind of like, I had a phase where I wore a lot of wigs, but I kind of wanted to take a break.
But would you say that it was because you couldn't take care of your hair or you really did not like your natural hair for a while?
I was lazy.
Or you were just lazy.
And see, that's why when it comes bad, when you would rather wear fake hair than take care of your real hair, you know what I'm saying?
Mm.
No. What about the people who just do it to experiment and have fun? I guess that's different.
Then, good! I'm talking about people who actually don't like their hair, because I know hair is a lot.
I feel like that the real thing we're just saying is you have to appreciate your natural self.
Right, right.
As well as have fun with makeup or wigs or weaves or whatever.
Right. Wow.
Yeah, I mean, you guys got locks because, I mean, you wanted to, I don't know, you just like that style. Not because you hated your natural hair, right?
No. I love my natural hair. I love the way how it grows and everything.
Cap, yeah. You guys were frustrated.
No, I didn't say I hate. I wasn't. But
no, I love my natural hair.
I just said that.
I love my natural hair now, I said.
No, I mean before.
Before. Okay,
I didn't hate my hair.
To take care of.
Yeah.
So. I mean, I'm just trying to, I don't want to hear your thought. Like, did you have bad self-esteem? Like,
No. I still loved my hair. I didn't hate my hair and I didn't feel like I looked bad with the hair I had. I had like a full afro sometimes. Like,
her hair was very thick. Shanae's hair was very thick.
But I did not have the tools to take care of it, or I didn't know where to find the tools to take care of my hair. Even though there was YouTube, but I didn't really think about that at the moment. I didn't have like that mindset to go that far.
Okay, guys. Your 9-year-old comes in your bathroom. She's crying. And she's like, Mom, all the kids in my school is wearing makeup. I want to look pretty too.
I would encourage her and say, look.
No.
Well, I mean, I would say no. But I would be like, first of all, you are 9. You don't need to look older. Because the thing is about makeup is it definitely makes you look older.
Yeah.
That's what makeup basically does.
Way too much at young.
And when you're 9, that doesn't need to be a thing you're thinking about. You need to be satisfied with the way you look.
Yes.
And you're always going to be... The thing about wearing makeup when you're young, it's like you're not done developing facial feature-wise.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, so no stress. Go play with a Barbie.
Drastically different than from me at... 13, at 10, even 16, I look different.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely.
I don't know, you've always kind of looked the same.
Everyone thinks that you're younger than you are, Shasha.
Everyone thinks you guys are younger than you are.
No. Literally, I heard someone gasp once when they heard your age.
People scream out in horror when they find out you're like almost you're 22 and you look like you're 11.
The thing is that makeup makes you look older, and that's why we've always been mistaken for teenagers. Still.
Has that bothered you guys?
For being mistaken as young? No, it doesn't bother me.
It doesn't bother me, not at all.
I have people that I literally know, some of my own friends, who thought I was younger than I am.
Yeah, but it's also the way how you carry yourself. Well, actually, no. The way how you carry yourself, you actually carry yourself more older than you are younger. So.
Listen, Sky Jackson has looked the same for years.
She looks young.
She looks the same.
But she wears makeup, though. I think it's just more of her body. Because
yeah, it has to be. Like, she's tiny, but also her face looks the same.
Yeah, her face does look the same.
Literally. So, I mean.
But how come that never bothered us? Like, us just being young, looking young.
Yeah, because to some people, it bothers them to look young. But really, think about it.
Yeah.
At some point, you want to look younger. Like, you know, when you're older, then you're like, wait a minute. Then people start getting Botox and they start getting like, they start getting fillers and stuff, or taking like fat off or whatever.
Right.
Because they want to look younger. But I would argue that stay away from a lot of, well, first of all, eat healthy.
Take care of your body, yes.
Make healthy choices and don't wear makeup as often as you think you want to.
Alicia Keys, she stopped wearing makeup for years now.
Yeah.
I remember it was on the headline.
She looks really good.
Yeah, she does look really good.
I remember on the topic of makeup, Lady Gaga, when she was filming, what was it called again, that film? Her film.
Oh, I know.
On the deep end.
Is it?
Star Is Born?
Star Is Born. She was not allowed to wear makeup for the film, and when she tried to sneak it in a little bit, a few makeup, but she had to wipe it off because she wasn't, for her role, she wasn't allowed to wear makeup. They wanted her to be natural. So I thought that was very interesting.
But what is it? Makeup. How come we're not in this like sort of natural phase? How come it's just never here? It's always just different makeup trends, but there's just never a natural phase.
Because there's no profit from being natural.
Ooh!
Profit. Ooh.
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 I mean, think about it. I mean, there could be if people invested in skincare, but then the makeup companies would suffer. But the thing is, if they work together, you know, mess up your skin a little bit with makeup, fix it with skincare.
What?
Think about it. They both profit from that. But if you only focus on natural, then only the skincare profits come.
Ooh. So we can start a company like a makeup company and then a skincare company. And we're like we give them like these toxic makeup ingredients. And then he can clean it up with this.
Why are you creating a master plan?
An evil plan. I mean, but you're right. I feel like everyone needs to prioritize skincare first and foremost.
I mean,
makeup.
I mean, like, I agree wholeheartedly. I mean, like, I feel like I need to invest myself in more skincare. I mean, like, I don't use makeup, so it's like I need to, you know, substitute, you know, get those serums and those face sprays. Yeah.
Face sprays?
You know those rose water mists?
No?
You never use one?
You never use
one? No?
It's pretty relaxing, you know. It smells.
What are you guys talking about?
You never use a rose water spray.
Mm-mm.
You should try it.
It's really nice.
You spray it on your face and it's just kind of hydrating.
I will literally buy you one, Shasha, because honestly, we need to invest. Me and you.
Trust me, I've got enough water. It's from my tap.
No. There needs to be more than just water. There needs to be soap involved. There needs to be some serums.
I do use soap and stuff. I'm just saying,
rose water is refreshing.
So you can tell who prioritizes skincare more.
Okay, yeah, you know.
Wait, tell us your a little bit of it. You don't have to say the whole thing, but what you remember.
Let me reveal my secrets, you know. So this is what I do. Most days, I wash my face with some water. I don't do soap every day because it dries out the skin.
Oh, yeah. She has very
dry skin. My skin is even different from, say, Shalom's skin is slightly more oily.
I do soap every day because my skin is oily more.
So I don't do soap every day, but I will do water for sure. Then, of course, I do some serum. I do hyaluronic acid. I think that's what it's called. Yeah, that's what it's called, right? Sometimes I do niacinamide, and then I put on some Neutrogena face cream after those.
For me, I wash Cetaphil. I've been using the same Cetaphil. I forgot what the type. I think it was specifically for face. not the bar one. I don't know why, who would use the bar one, but I use that Cetaphil, scrub, scrub, scrub. Then I put on what was called again, aloe vera oil and jojoba oil, a little bit of mix of the two. I don't put too much because my face is more oily, but just to hydrate it a little bit more, I use a mix of those. It's really hydrating.
Yeah.
Nice.
I should try the rose water though.
Nice.
Okay. Okay.
You know, it's cool. Really keeping it really,
oh,
really
I have a whole bunch of products, but I kind of want to list them, but I don't feel like getting it. So I will tell you guys another time.
Another time? Okay, well, what do you do?
Another
do you
time?
Like wash your face with soap every day? Like what is
it? Oh yeah. Like every night at least I would wash it.
Well, you should wash it in the morning too. Cause like,
well, night and morning. It just depends. It's either, I vary. It's either night or day where I wash it. That use a whole bunch of other products.
If you wash soap twice a day, they'll want to dry your skin out with the soap?
Not if you have oily skin.
Oh, yeah, she does have oily skin. You got to know your type. You got to know your skin.
Well, you got to know. You got to do what's best for your skin.
Wait, hold on. I'm going to get one of the, two of my products.
No, wait. Shalom is leaving the building right now. For now, let's talk about something besides. What is your, do you have a hair care routine? I know you have sister locks, but like.
The thing is about with sister locks is you don't really need a hair care routine. You can oil it every, you know, couple weeks, but like, and then wash it every couple weeks, but like, you don't really have to do much to maintain it. Like, you don't need to put creams.
Wow.
You don't need to, like, what you have to do with your hair, put protective styles in it and stuff like
that. Well, it just shows me that you don't need to put products in your hair. Because look at Shanae's hair. I don't know if
you guys... No, you do need to put products in your hair if it's like that. But because locks, the only way they start locking is if you don't put a bunch of stuff in it. If you start putting stuff in it, it'll start slipping.
No, but think about it. The way to grow your hair, because Shanae's hair was shoulder length when she started.
Oh, but think
about it. Now it's mid-waist length.
No, but think about it like this. Dreads are almost like a protective style. They're like braids, but dreads. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Think about it like that. It's not going to like start breaking
itself
because it's basically it's a constant protective style.
So the secret to growing your hair is protective style so it doesn't break.
Yes, that's what I would say it is. Not necessarily dreads and not necessarily not putting products, but keeping your hair in protective styles.
Wow, that's interesting. Mm-hmm. I keep my hair in afro 24/7.
That's the thing. It won't be protected at the ends and stuff because it's always out. But if you have it in protective styles,
it's gonna grow. Shanae's hair grew so fast. Oh, Shalom is back with her hair skincare products.
Okay, so what do you have, Shalom?
Okay, so I have Hydro Bio Serum.
So what is it? It is moisturizing concentrate.
Yes, and I also use Hydro Bio Gel Cream as well.
Okay, more stuff. I don't exactly know what it is.
The makeup artist in LA used it, and then mom ordered it.
Okay.
So yeah, I also use Insta Natural.
Oh, yeah. Niacinamide Serum. It has hyaluronic acid, vitamin E. All of that is really good for skin. I highly recommend using niacinamide.
I need to buy more. This one's almost out. I also use
Insta Natural. I love Insta Natural. That's what I use.
Yeah, Insta Natural Vitamin C Cleanser.
That's what I use for my skin to wash my face.
And I also use
Mario Badescu. Is that how you say it?
I think so.
Wow, sweet.
Anyways, that's the rose water.
So yeah. Oh, Shasha, try some on your face.
Yes. Try.
Ready?
No.
Close your eyes.
No, you get this microphone.
Okay, move the microphone.
Ready?
Wait, I might be allergic to it.
No, you're not gonna be allergic to it.
Trust me, it's natural.
That smelled good. Why did you put it straight to my eyes?
What?
You're supposed to close like your eyes.
You didn't tell me to.
You didn't close your eyes?
No.
Shasha.
I didn't know when you were going to spray it.
I'm sorry.
Well, how does it make your face feel?
It just smells really good.
You want me to buy you one?
No, thank you.
It smells good. No, thank you.
It smells really good.
Oh, yeah.
It's like I'm rubbing it across my face. And
That's what I'm saying. It's refreshing.
Oh, my goodness.
But basically what we're saying, guys, is take care of who you are naturally, because then you'll learn to appreciate yourself more, and you won't necessarily feel pushed to wear makeup if you don't really want to, but like society pressures, you know?
Yeah, and it's okay to have fun with makeup, you know? Just appreciate your natural self first, you know?
Because deep down, you gotta make sure you appreciate yourself and love yourself deep down. It's not even really about like, we're not even trying to criticize anybody for wearing makeup or anything like that.
No.
We just wanna make sure that everybody has the best mindset first as they're going into, as you guys are getting into makeup or getting into wearing wigs or getting into wearing even different clothes and stuff like that.
Right.
I think the next topic should definitely be hair.
Like,
yeah. Ooh. I don't know. What do you guys think?
That's a good idea.
That is a good idea.
But anyways,
guys. We hope we were able to, you know, have a nice conversation with you all, that we're thought-provoking, and, you know, thinking about what you're going to change in your life. Maybe do a skin routine if you don't have one. Stuff like that, you know. You know? But anyways, thank you guys for joining us in this podcast. We will see you in the next episode.
Bye. Bye.